What is the difference between resizing and compressing images? Websites are filled with images, big, small, and some with stunning high definition. Although website visitors may want to see all those images, they often do not wish to wait long for the images and the remainder of your webpage to load. Conversely, if your small business website only contains tiny, low-resolution images, it might load quickly, but it is not nearly as visually appealing and can give the impression that your brand is low quality. Two important image techniques exist to create fast, visually appealing websites. Resizing an image with HTML attributes, or CSS, not recommended. Images consist of pixels that are points of data that make up the image. Resizing an image is typically thought of as simply changing the visual dimensions of the image. Many website tools may allow you to upload a large image and then automatically or drag and drop resize it visually to your intended placement on your webpage. However, your website is still likely loading the full image even if you don't realize it. What happens is the full image of 1920 by 1080 loads in the background and is resized visually, either in CSS or HTML attributes, to the desired display size. Unfortunately, in this case, the user's browser still was forced to download the high-resolution image, which negatively impacts page speed and the user experience. On the other hand, there is a way to resize the image properly by lowering the resolution and thus exporting fewer pixels of data. Some content management systems, CMS, will have tools built in that truly do essentially take the original image uploaded and create multiple smaller versions of the image. Compressing images. Image compression utilizes specialized mathematical techniques to reduce the file size while maintaining its resolution and visual dimensions. Think of it as a way to fit more data in the same amount of area. For a more technical perspective, compression techniques attempt to reduce the complexity of an image structure, thus requiring less data to store while attempting to leave visual fidelity uncompromised. The only caveat is that too much compression can somewhat reduce image quality, just like being too squished at a concert can be a wee bit uncomfortable and ruin the experience. It's important to balance both true resizing and compressing of your images to ensure your website is visually appealing and quick to load as possible. How do I start compressing and optimizing images? First of all, you can use simple web apps like Kraken to help you resize and compress images in a flash. Additionally, some content management systems also have components and plugins that can be added to help make the process more automated as a part of your website publishing workflow. It's always advisable to talk to a professional web developer if you aren't sure how your images are being handled. Ultimately, resizing your image is critically important to minimizing wasted time loading an unnecessarily large image.